Morning, dear students. I hope you all are safe at home and enjoying the holidays. So now studies time. So today we should study the full forms that are related to the chapters that we have studied. The first one is computer. We should know it's a full form, and the full form is commonly operating machine, particular used in technical education and research. OS stands for operating system. Mac stands for media, SS control. Next one is Unix. Unix is a kind of operating system, and it stands for Unitext Information and Computing System. Next is CUI. CUI is a kind of interface, and it stands for Command User Interface. MS-DOS is an example of it that runs with the help of commands only. Next is GUI. GUI stands for Graphical User Interface. Next is MS. MS stands for Microsoft. It is a part of Office. MS Office. MS Office are having various parts: MS PowerPoint, MS Excel, MS Paint, MS Outlook. So these all are the parts of MS. DTP. It is a kind of software. It stands for Desktop Publishing Software. Next is DBMS. DBMS stands for Database Management System. DBMS software is Database Management Software. CLC, it is the shortcut of, or you can say its full form is Calculator. The next one is CAD. It stands for Computer Aided Design. So these are the basic full forms that are related to the chapters that we had studied. So let's revise these all. Computer stands for Commonly Operating Machine, Particular Used in Technical Education and Research. OS, Operating System. Mac, Media, SS Control. Unix, Uniplexed Information and Computing System. CUI, Command User Interface. GUI, Graphical User Interface. MS stands for Microsoft. DTP, Desktop Publishing Software. DBMS, Database Management System. CLC, Calculator. And CAD, Computer Aided Design. Now we should study the basic shortcut commands also. Basic shortcut command. Basic command means that we use frequently for any program. We should use these all. So we should be aware about these all full forms, that what are their uses. They are, first is save. To save any file, we use Ctrl+S. To make a new file, we use the shortcut commands Ctrl+N. To open a new file, we, or you can say existing फाइल यू विल यूज द शॉर्टकट कमांड कंट्रोल प्लस ओ. इफ यू हैव टू क्लोज अ डॉक्यूमेंट देन यू विल चूज द की कंट्रोल प्लस डब्ल्यू. इफ यू वॉन्ट टू गेट एग्जिट फ्रॉम एनी प्रोग्राम विंडो सो यू विल यूज द ऑप्शन ऑल्ट प्लस एफ फोर. ओके, वॉट इज द डिफरेंस बिटवीन क्लोज एंड एग्जिट? देयर इज अ स्लाइट डिफरेंस बिटवीन दीज टू. इफ यू आर वर्किंग इन एन प्रोग्राम विंडो एंड यू हैव मेड अ फाइल, इफ यू आर प्रेसिंग और कंट्रोल प्लस डब्ल्यू शॉर्टकट कीज कॉम्बिनेशन, then it will only close the file that you are working on. The running file that you are working on, that file, it will close that file only. If you are using exit option, it will directly gets you out from the program window. Means the program window will get closed. And here, you are closing only the particular file. Next is cut. Cut means if we want to cut any data, so you use the command control plus x. And if you have cut the data and you want to paste it at other location, so you will use the option control plus v. Control plus x for cut, control plus v for paste. Next is copy. That everyone uses openly. Control plus c. What is the difference between cut and paste and copy and paste? Paste is to paste the contents that you have copied or you have cut. If you have used the paste with cut, then it will erase the content from the previous location and it will send the text or it will paste the text or the data to the new location. If you are using copy paste, so at both the location the data will remain present. Example, suppose you want to do cut and paste. So you want to cut this x from here and you want to paste it at here. So if you are using cut, it will be erased from here and it will come this side. And if we are using copy paste, so copy paste. So what will happen? You are copying it at this location, so at this resultant, at both the location you will find this data. This is the difference between cut and paste and copy paste. Okay, next are find. Everyone finds any data. Suppose you are having a document file and you are finding a specific word and you are not able to find it, so you will use a shorter command for it, that is find. And this find you can do by using the option control plus F. Okay. Next is replace. Replace word you all know. It means you are replacing. Already if any data is there, you are replacing it by the new data. So suppose any word is, suppose it is X here and you want to replace it by Y. So you will use the option replace. The shortcut command for it is control plus H to find the data, control plus F to replace the data, control plus H. Next is go to. Okay. Suppose you want to go to a specific page. You have made a report and it includes 10 pages. And you want to directly want to go to second number page, fourth number page, so you will use the option go to. And go to command is control plus G. With the help of this go to command, you can easily go to the page. When you will click or when you will use the control plus G shortcut key combination, it will ask you for the page. On which page number you want to go. If you have written here 2, so directly you will switch on the page number 2. Other shortcut commands are thank you.
mode.
What do you know when our data or when our text you highlights in bold? Means if any data is in this way, you have darkened it and the width also increased, so that is known as bold. And bold you can do by using the shortcut command Control plus B. If you want to make the text italic, in italic form if you want to shift it, then you will use the command Control plus I. Control plus I is used to make the text italic. Next is underline. If you want to underline the text, means if you want to draw a line, horizontal line under the text, so you will use the shortcut command Control plus U. This is used to make the text underline. Bold, italic, underline. These all we speak together. Next is alignment. Basically, alignment are of four types. Alignments are of four types: left, right, center, justify. What is the difference between these all? Left alignment. Left alignment means you are shifting the text left side. Right alignment means you are shifting the text right side. Center alignment means you are shifting the text at the center. And what is justify alignment? Justify alignment means you are keeping the text in this way. Suppose this is the page. So, left side means this text will start from this side and it will not leave a space here. It will be continue. It will not leave a single space, not this side, not this side. This is known as justify alignment. So, shortcut commands of these are, for left alignment it is Control plus L. For right alignment, you should use the command Control plus R to write the alignment. Next is center alignment. To make the alignment as center, you will use the command Control plus E. E is used for the center alignment. Why we are not using here? See, because one key combination we can use only. Because here Control plus C is used to copy, so we can't use C here. Here we will use the command Control plus E. Next is justify alignment. This alignment is done by using the shortcut key combination Control plus J. J stands for justify. Next is subscript and superscript. Subscript and superscript. What are these? Subscript means in maths, or you can say for the superscript, subscript, you are using formulas in maths. So if you are using it like this, x square, y square, if you are keeping the number as a power, so it is known as superscript. And if you are keeping the text like CO2, H2O, CaCO3, means these are the chemical formula. For science we use subscript and for mathematics we use superscript. In one we are raising it as a power and in one we are keeping these all as a base. So to make the text subscript we use the combination Control plus Shift plus equal to. And if we want to use the text as a superscript, so we will use Control plus Shift plus plus sign. Control plus Shift plus plus sign. Next is increase the size. If you want to increase the font size, so you will use the key Control plus the arrow, increasing arrow. If you want to decrease the size, then you will use the combination of the keys this. Okay. If you want to open the start menu, it is available. So you will use the command Control plus escape here.
means to open start menu. You will use the command control plus escape, and if you want to open the Windows task manager where you manage all the tasks related to the computer system, then you will use the Windows task manager, and it can be done by the command control plus shift plus ESC. What is the full form of this ESC? ESC stands for escape. It is a key that is present in our keyboard. Okay, so its shortcut is ESC. So these were the shortcut commands and the full forms that are related to the chapter 1 and 2. So you all should revise these all at home, and you will make a table in beautiful handwriting as a homework. Okay, so you all will use pencil to draw the box, and you will use the